Is there anyone in your family that's not an entrepreneur?
No, and being an entrepreneur is something that my parents raised us to be, essentially. I think most families, I don't know, around the dinner table talk about, I actually don't know what most families do, but my family always talked about running a business around the dinner table. While it was my parents asking us what we thought of their work problems, or my parents encouraging us to brainstorm new business ideas, we were constantly coming up with new family businesses. And that type of creativity, or I guess confidence, I think is instilled at a very young age. I have two kids and I bring them to my office all the time. I love for them to see what I do and brainstorm with them about what programming my company can help with or do. And I think it comes from the beginning.
Yeah. I'd be curious, what would you say to parents who are very interested in that? How do I teach my child to be more entrepreneurial? What were some things that maybe you do with your kids or that your parents did with you that maybe anyone could emulate?
I really think it's that brainstorming about what business you can invent, what problem you can solve. Mm-hmm. And when you find a problem, it's not just figuring out what was wrong with the problem, but truly how can you solve that problem? And then how can you make money solving that problem?
Yeah.
And it's also talking about money. I mean, let's be honest, the majority of the time entrepreneurs are, while there might be some philanthropicness in there, a lot of it is this drive and a financial incentive. So talking about money as something that can be earned, and that the sky's the limit, I think it's just something that you instill in your children at the beginning.
I remember reading Robert Kiyosaki's Rich Dad, Poor Dad, mm-hmm. and he talked about how he essentially had two dads. And the poor dad was always really tense and uncomfortable around that topic of money, never wanted to discuss it. And whenever he paid for something, you know, he'd get this sorrowful look on his face. And so he internalized this mindset growing up that money is this bad thing. It's something to be worried about. At best, it's a necessary evil. And it wasn't until years later where he met his rich dad and he developed this sense of, hey, like, it's okay to talk casually about it.
You know,
just by having a conversation about money that's not all tense and dramatic can be so liberating in terms of the possibilities you create in your own life.
Well, and I think my parents always talked about if we wanted something, it wasn't necessarily about saving for it, but about earning it. So it's that money that can be earned. And how do you, if you want something, you've got to go out and figure out how to earn the money to pay for it. And that's how I've done things in my business. It's if we want to grow a certain aspect of the business, or we want to invest in, I don't know, a new piece of technology, we have to earn that money versus just saving for it. And it's obviously there is saving that is necessary, but the idea that money is fluid and that you can get more of it, that's a different mindset of constantly trying to hoard money.